Hi, my name is Claire Tomlin, and this is Module 5 in our series in the course 221A, Linear Systems at Berkeley. And today we're going to be talking about matrix representations of linear maps. So the single most important thing to take out of this module is how to construct a matrix representation of a linear map between finite dimensional vector spaces. Okay, so we're going to start with that statement. Any linear map between finite dimensional vector spaces, can be represented as matrix multiplication. Okay, now this is actually a very useful fact because it allows us to turn what may be quite abstract definitions of maps, as long as they're linear and as long as they're operating between finite dimensional vector spaces, to turn them into matrix multiplication, which is easy. Okay, so let's try to understand what that means. And let's actually make an emphasis here. So the first thing is the map is linear. And the second is that we have to be operating between finite dimensional vector spaces. Okay, so what we're going to do in the module today is actually derive what the linear map is, how you would derive the matrix multiplication given that you have some definition of what the linear map is. So we're going to do this. We'll use the same notation as we've been using all along. That's A is a map, and A is a linear map. It's mapping our domain U over to our codomain V. And remember our notation that A operates on an element U and gives us an element over in the codomain, and this is in the range of A. And so what we're going to now show is A times a vector U is equal to V, where A is now a matrix. So this script A represents a linear map, which could be quite abstract, and this block A is our matrix representation. And now I've been a little bit sloppy here. I've used U and V to represent elements of the domain and elements of the range. And that's fine, but I've used the same elements U and V over here, which is not necessarily the case, as we're going to see as we derive this matrix multiplication. Okay, so let's sort of keep that in mind and go forward. Okay, so now we'll use a few definitions of things that we've talked about already. We're gonna construct bases for both our domain and our codomain. And that's an important step, is that this matrix representation depends on the bases that you're using for the domain and the codomain, respectively. So if you choose a basis for U and you choose a basis for V and you have a definition for A, you can construct the matrix capital A. If you change the basis, then the matrix A changes. Okay, so let's see that. We'll use a basis for U, so basis, and I'm just going to use a set of vectors U1 up to UN for U. So we're going to assume that U is an n-dimensional vector space and V is an m-dimensional vector space. So let's call these bases. So this is for U and VJ. J equals 1 to M is a basis for V. Okay, so what does it mean to be a basis? It means that any vector U can be represented as a linear combination of elements in the basis, and any vector in V, respectively, can be represented as a linear combination of the basis vectors. And it's what we discussed when we discussed bases is that representation, once you've chosen the basis, the representation, the coordinates of any vector U or any vector V in those spaces, the coordinates are unique with respect to the given basis. Okay, so So we know that suppose we choose a vector, let's say x, any x in U has a representation with respect to that basis, but it's a unique representation. There exists a unique set of coordinates, and we'll use the coordinate vector x to represent our set of coordinates x, I equals 1 to n, such that x is equal to the summation, we use j or I, it doesn't matter, what do I use in the notes, j. The summation from j equals 1 to n of xij uj. Okay, so there exists a unique coordinate vector for any vector x. All right, so now let's operate on that vector x using A. So A operating on x is equal to A operating on, let's write it out in terms of the basis vectors, summation from j equals 1 to n of xij uj. And A is linear, so we can invoke the property of superposition, and this becomes the summation from j equals 1 to n of xij A of uj. Okay, so that's bilinearity of the map A. All right, now each of these vectors, A operating on the basis vectors in U, that gives us a vector over in the space V. So each A of uj is an element of V, and therefore it can be written in terms of the basis vectors of V using a unique coordinate set with respect to that basis. So it has a unique representation in terms of the basis vectors given by the following. A of uj is equal to, and we're going to write it out in terms of the same kind of notation. So here we have m basis vectors. And I'm going to use aij to represent the coordinates of a of uj written with respect to the basis vectors in V. So I is the index for the set of basis vectors in V. OK, so that means, so the j here indicates that this is the operation of taking the jth basis element in U, operating on that basis element using A, and I get some representation in terms of the basis vectors over in V. Okay, so for example, A of U1 would give me some summation over I of AI1 VI and A of U2, etc. Okay, so now we have that relationship. And so now we can see how we might use this relationship to construct this matrix representation of this linear map. And in all of these, I'm still using this, although it's a little hard to see, this script A to represent our linear map notation. Okay, so now we can go back to AX. So I've got A of UJ written in terms of the VIs. So now I can go back and write AX. And that's going to be the summation from j equals 1 up to n of the xij's, the coordinates over in the domain, a of uj, but a of uj is given by the summation from I equals 1 to m of aij vi. And these are finite summations, so I can rearrange the summations there and rewrite that as the summation from I equals 1 to m, and I'll bring this summation in, times the summation from j equals 1 to n of aij xij vi. AX is a vector over in the codomain, or a subset of that, in the range of A. And so AX has a coordinate representation in terms of the basis vectors. So summation from I equals 1 to M of A to I VI. But as we know, the coordinate representation is unique. So this tells us that the coordinates of AX, A to I, are just given by this summation here. Okay, so what we end up with is a linear equation describing how the coordinates of the vector X change under the map A. So we end up with an equation which is thus A to I is equal to the summation from J equals 1 to N of Aij Ci. And that's true for all I's and for all J's. So it's true for I going from 1 up to M, and for J going from 1 up to N. So I can take that equation, which is written in terms of the individual coordinates, and I can rewrite it in matrix form, and I'll let I and J range over these indices, and I end up with vector eta is equal to A times vector xi, where A is a matrix whose individual ijth element is aij constructed as we just did. Okay, so let's take a look at this equation. What we have here is a matrix equation in which we've constructed a matrix A just by looking at the corresponding coordinates of vectors in the domain and the codomain using the bases that we've chosen, the bases ui and vj. We've constructed a matrix A which takes the coordinate representation of the vector in the domain and maps it to the coordinate representation of the vector over in, of the resulting AX over in the codomain. So the matrix A that we construct is it multiplies the coordinate representation of the corresponding vector. So earlier when I wrote the general representation, and remember I wrote, if we have a linear map A and it operates on a vector U and gives us a vector V, what we were going to construct is a matrix which operates on a vector U and gives us a vector V, and that's a corresponding matrix multiplication. This isn't really true. What is true is that what A does is it takes the coordinates of U with respect to the basis in U, and it gives us the coordinates of V in the basis of the codomain. So this is only true if we're dealing with bases, like if we're looking at Rn or Rm, where the bases are the standard basis elements, and then the vectors themselves are the same as the coordinate vectors. But in general, the important thing to remember here is we've constructed a matrix A which takes that, it represents that linear map in terms of matrix multiplication on the coordinate vectors. And finally, what we can say about that matrix, in the process of constructing it, we came up with a defining statement. So when we constructed it, we basically constructed it. One of the first things we did was we wrote down A of uj, so that was the jth basis element in the domain, is equal to the summation from I equals 1 to M of Aij Vi. That's our defining statement for A, because these Aijs are the elements of the matrix A. And so the thing that we should remember when we're thinking about matrix multiplication of, or matrix representation of linear maps, is the following statement. And this is good to remember. So good to remember that the matrix A is defined as follows. The jth column, of the matrix A so that's capital A is linear map A operating on the jth basis element in the domain written with respect to the basis elements in the codomain. So expressed expressed with respect to the basis elements VI. Okay, where these are, this is the basis of the domain and this is the basis of the codomain. Okay, so the jth column of the matrix A is A of UJ, the linear map operating on UJ expressed with respect to the basis elements over in the codomain. Okay, so a recap. What we've done today is we've looked at a linear map between finite dimensional vector spaces. It's important that those vector spaces are finite dimensional. Otherwise, we wouldn't have been able to do these finite summations and actually construct the matrix. So we've shown that a linear map between finite dimensional vector spaces can be represented in terms of matrix multiplication on the corresponding coordinate vectors. And we have constructed that matrix multiplication in terms of this defining statement. So now, if you're given vector spaces, you're given a linear map, and the vector spaces are finite dimensional, and you're given the properties of the linear map, then you can construct the matrix representation using these definitions. Okay, so that concludes our module on matrix representations of linear maps.